The You're Two There podcast, it's time to start the show. Be sure to hold on tight, here we go. Exploring all the different Disney destinations. You're Two There, it's time to start the fun.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Ear to There podcast, Walt Disney World Word of the Week. I am your host, Phil Gramlich. And with this complimentary podcast to the Ear to There podcast, each and every week, I will give you a new Walt Disney World word and then give you some history, some tips, some hints, some background about that Walt Disney World word. But this week, before we get into the word of the week, I want to announce our winner for last week's trivia question at the end of the Word of the Week podcast. Last week's question was, in addition to the Morocco Pavilion, a section of a different pavilion in World Showcase is not lit up during illuminations. Which pavilion has that section that does not light up? And of the hundreds, of the few people that called the voice line with the correct answer, I had to pick one randomly. And congratulations to...
Hi, Phil. My name is Penny Gantz, and I love listening to the podcast. Wanted to call and give you the answer to the trivia question. The answer is Norway. Have a great day, and thanks again. Love listening to the show. Bye.
That's right, Penny Gantz. You are the winner of the Walt Disney World $25 gift card. Please email me your mailing address at phil@eartotheretravel.com, and I'll get that right out to you in the next couple of weeks. So thank you to everyone who called the voice line with the answers. And be sure to listen each and every week because you never know when I'm going to ask the next trivia question. Okay, on to this week's Word of the Week. And this week's Walt Disney World Word of the Week is brought to you by the letter J. J for jungle. And no, I'm not going to go into an Axl Rose Guns N' Roses song, nor am I going to start belting out the soundtrack from The Lion King. This week's Word of the Week is all about the Jungle Cruise. Now, the Jungle Cruise has always been and will continue to be one of my favorite attractions in all of Walt Disney World and Disneyland. It's also featured in other parks around the world, but I haven't been to those, so I really can't speak on how great they are, but I'm sure they're fantastic. So the true history of the Jungle Cruise starts all the way back in 1948 with Walt Disney and his first true life adventure film. Between 1948 and 1960, the Disney Company produced a whole bunch of nature documentaries that were the true life adventure film series. And believe it or not, these movies were very, very wildly popular. They won 8 Academy Awards, and they actually went on to inspire not only the Jungle Cruise, but the Disney nature films that are in theaters these days. So back to Walt Disney and the true life adventure films. He, when he was building Disneyland, he wanted a boat attraction where you could float through the rivers of the world and see actual real life living animals on the banks of these famous rivers. Walt was eventually talked out of the idea of live animals because, as we know from Kilimanjaro safaris these days, animals have a mind of their own, and they're not going to just kind of sit around and wait to be seen by the guests. But what will sit around and wait to be seen by guests coming through Disneyland? Audio animatronic animals. And that is exactly what Disneyland decided to use for the Jungle Cruise in the 1950s. So going back to the Disneyland version, originally, the tone of the Jungle Cruise was very serious. It was almost like a nature documentary. As I said, it was based on the True Life Adventure series, particularly the African Lion movie and the great Humphrey Bogart movie, The African Queen. Well, Humphrey Bogart and Katharine Hepburn. I don't want to forget or lose sight of the fact that Katharine Hepburn was also in that movie. Oh, and I should also mention that The African Queen was not an actual true life adventure movie. It was a real movie that was with Humphrey Bogart and Katharine Hepburn. But of course, now I can't get the idea of Humphrey Bogart crawling around on the ground like a lion and roaring. I promise he was not doing this during The African Queen. Anyway, so it did start out as a very serious, a very documentary-like trip down the rivers of the world. But in 1962, it turned into a more humorous, more comic spiel like we are used to today. And they added in the jokes and let the skippers play around with the audience and the guests just a little bit. Now, before we talk a little bit about the Magic Kingdom's version of the Jungle Cruise, I've heard of a great story that talks about Walt Disney and his constant need to quote-unquote plus the parks or make them better, always evolving Disneyland, always evolving everything that he did in the parks. Basically, the way the story goes was Walt was in the park when he heard a young boy talking to his mom about the Jungle Cruise and said, "Mom, I really want to go on that ride." And his mom said, no, we're not going on it this time. We rode that last time. We already saw it." That didn't sit well with Walt Disney. He always wanted there to be new things, to be new adventures. He wanted there to be new things to see. So he was always trying to outdo himself, always trying to quote unquote plus the attractions. Okay, so when Magic Kingdom opened on October 1st, 1971, hey, they just had their 45th anniversary, by the way. So happy 45th birthday to the Magic Kingdom and to Walt Disney World. Okay, so the Jungle Cruise in the Magic Kingdom is set as a British outpost on the Amazon River, and it's operated by the fictional Jungle Cruise Navigation Company, who, by the way, are the same folks that operate that new-ish restaurant across the way in Adventureland from the Jungle Cruise. Now, one of my favorite parts about the Jungle Cruise isn't the attraction itself, but it's the queue. The queue is full of all kinds of cool props and hidden jokes and little gags. You have to really look around, read everything, look up, look down, look all around in order to get all of those little gags and jokes that are hidden throughout the queue. And while you're in the queue, there's some great music and narration that are played, so try to listen to that. You'll hear a lot of gags and jokes about the attraction itself. It's a lot of fun to kind of take a minute and just listen and hear what's going on all around you. It's a lot of fun. The narration, the spiel of the queue is fantastic. Okay, once you board your boat and meet your Jungle Cruise skipper, that's when the attraction really starts to be a lot of fun. But this attraction, more than I think any other in all of Walt Disney World, is really made or broken by your skipper, by the host of your attraction. So as I said earlier, you go throughout some of the most famous rivers of the world. I think you start off in the Amazon, you go to the Congo River, the Nile River, the Mekong River. It's a very cool 7-minute, very fast trip through the rivers of the world. While on your trip, you'll see lions, you'll see tigers, you'll see elephants, you see hippos, crocodiles, the natives that are hiding in the weeds and the bushes. You'll see Trader Sam himself, which is one of my favorite parts of the attraction. And you'll hear, usually your skipper will say something like, "There's old Trader Sam, head salesman of the area. Business has been shrinking lately, so this week only, Sam's offering a 2-for-1 special. 2 of his for 1 of yours." Of course, he's talking about your head. But don't worry, it's all in good fun. And, well, as far as my experience has gone so far, it is always all in good fun. Then after you return to the dock and after your trek is over, your skipper will usually have something quite humorous to say as you disembark the boat. One of my favorites is, "If you feel your feet getting wet as you leave the boat, you've probably gone out the wrong side. Don't fall in the water as you leave. We'll have to charge you extra." I love that one. And I love mostly all the jokes at the Jungle Cruise. I think they're all incredibly fun and incredibly corny at the same time. And really, it adds to the charm and the nostalgia of that attraction. Okay, so a few cool facts about the Jungle Cruise in the Magic Kingdom. Okay, fun fact number one. Near the hippo pool, there is the back half of an airplane. This airplane is actually a Lockheed Model 12 Electra Jr. And it's an actual plane. The other half of that plane is actually found in Disney's Hollywood Studios on the Great Movie Ride at the Casablanca scene. So when Rick and Elsa are there saying their goodbyes and a plane starts up, that's the other half of that plane. All right, cool fact number two. One of the boats on the Magic Kingdom's Jungle Cruise, and let me see if I can pronounce this correctly because I'm actually terrible at pronouncing things, but the Sankuru Sadie actually sank. That's right, it sank at the Magic Kingdom in 2004. They were actually able to fix the boat, and it still is in the attraction today. And cool fact number three, I think this is three. Yeah, this is three. Cool fact number three. The Jungle Cruise during the holidays becomes the Jingle Cruise. So all kinds of fun holiday overlays are added to the queue, to the music in the queue, and to the attraction itself. Even the names of the boats are changed to reflect kind of a holiday theme. Oh, and the jokes, the skipper's jokes, very, very corny jokes, I might add, are also Christmas themed. So it's a lot of fun. It's very different to go during the holidays. So that should be something you kind of look at the next time you're going to be in Walt Disney World during the holidays. And as I mentioned earlier in the podcast, the other cool jungle association in the Magic Kingdom, still in Adventureland, is the Jungle Navigation Company Skipper Canteen, located across the way from the Jungle Cruise. This restaurant, I had a chance to try on my last couple of trips. I love it. They've changed the menu a little bit. I think when the menu first debuted, it was, I wouldn't say out there, but it was a little adventurous for some people. They've put in some more Americanized or less adventurous versions of the dishes. So it's a lot more family friendly now for people who may not be as adventurous with their palate and with what they eat. And to me, the coolest part about the attraction, besides all the nods to the Jungle Cruise, of course, is your server there is a former Jungle Cruise skipper, or so the story goes, and they will remain in character, at least the good ones will, throughout the meal. So it's a lot of fun. They make a lot of the same corny jokes. They tell a lot of fun stories. It's a great time. I really enjoyed it. I think it's something, if you're in the Magic Kingdom, try to get a reservation for it. It's a lot of fun. You'll enjoy it. Oh, and try the head-on shrimp. I had that as my meal the last time I went there. I thought it was phenomenal. And don't let the little heads that are on the shrimp scare you. You can pop them right off. Okay, and that's going to do it for this week's Ear to Their podcast, Walt Disney World Word of the Week. As always, thank you so much for listening. I hope you really enjoyed this episode. I absolutely love the Jungle Cruise. I love the new restaurant. I want everyone who's going to Magic Kingdom to go enjoy it. Or if you're going to Disneyland, enjoy the original Jungle Cruise. It's a lot of fun. A little different over there as well. And all I ask is if you did enjoy this episode or any of these episodes, please share them. Please tell somebody about them. The next time you're in the Magic Kingdom, you may be waiting in line for the Jungle Cruise. Tell the people around you all about the podcast. I really appreciate that. And just remember, there will be a new episode of the Ear to Their podcast, Walt Disney World Word of the Week, each and every Wednesday morning, as well as a Ear to Their podcast episode each and every Monday morning. So until next time, thank you for listening. Have a great week. Bye-bye.